Allahu Akbar.
Inshallah, our next speaker is Dr. Osama Bahlul. Dr. Osama is the welcome, Dr. Osama. Dr. Osama is the resident scholar of at the Islamic Center of Nashville, as well as a member of the Fiqh Council of North America and the affiliate Muslim chaplain at Vanderbilt University. He's a graduate of Al-Azhar University in Cairo, Egypt, where he earned a BA in Islamic Studies and a PhD in Comparative Religions. Dr. Bahlul's interest in comparative religions has led to nearly 20 years of experience in interfaith dialogue and collaborations between Muslim organizations and leaders from other faiths. Previously, Dr. Bahlul was Imam at the Islamic Center of Murfreesboro, where he supported the community through severe Islamic attacks while building the only mosque in Murfreesboro. Above all, Dr. Bahlul is a devoted husband to his wife, Ivy Bahlul, and a caring father to his three children. Dr. Osama, welcome. Mashallah, your topic today is Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man with a mission.
Yes, jazakumullahu khairan. Bismillah, walhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidina wa maulana rasulillah. Nas'a'ullah al-tawfiqa, al-ikhlas wa salam. When speaking about the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and speaking about his mission, I think it's a critical issue, because by identifying the mission, we might have the opportunity to evaluate our performance. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent with a very simple and big, in the same time, goal to make it easy for every one of us as a human to be what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala desire for us to be. Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Quran al-Kareem mentioned this, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be a mercy for the whole mankind. When asking any Muslim about the mission of Rasul, people will mention many ayat and many ahadith. But I really want to revisit this from a different perspective, because we need to be mindful of the mission of our beloved Prophet, because it should be ours. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came in a society, not only in Arabia, but within the Far East, we did not have much of system. People in Arabia, Al-Quran al-Kareem referred to them as وَإِن كُنْتُم مِّن قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُّبِينٍ. People were without any mission, without any system. They did not have even their own currency. And the level of discrimination within the society was troubling, to say the least. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and to convey to them the message of Islam and brought stability to the entire society. In a society while slavery was very much a common practice, actually was endorsed by the elite within the society, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not only speak against this, but the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with a method to free slaves. And the Rasul taught all of us that إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةَ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to magnify and to confirm the proper position within the human, which is the concept of equality, that people should be equal in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you can be better than others if you choose to, not really by your color, your age, or gender, but by what you have in your heart. Inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum. If you want to be better than everyone around you, have more taqwa, build a better relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be a better individual, then you can be a better individual in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam empowered the individuals through his vision to become free from any kind of dictatorship within the human. And even Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give each one of the people a direct access to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not a secret that we don't even have the concept of imams within our tradition. You can speak with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anytime. You don't need to ask for permission. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. فإني قريب means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is here for you. Just you need to ask. You need to speak. Knock on the door and the door will be open. Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said this beautifully when he mentioned that part of the power of Islam, part of the mission of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to eliminate the power of the clergy, the religious authority, by depending solely in the collective morality of the society. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us through some examples that we should be as an individual what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants or desire for us to be, empowering people around us, helping everyone to have an access to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salman al-Farisi was a slave when he became Muslim. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not only express sympathy to him, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught him and the people after him. He came with the concept of al-mukataba. Al-mukataba, when the slave will make a deal with his master to buy himself out. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught Salman to do this. He said, Salman, why don't you buy yourself out? Salman went to his master and made a deal that he will be free, a free man, if he were to plant 300 trees. Sayyidina Salman came back to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Rasul was a man with a mission, He was not a speaker, but Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was into action. When he asked Sayyidina Salman, what did you do? Salman said, Ya Rasulallah, I made this deal that I will be free after planting 300 trees for my master. Rasul looked to Sahaba and said, A'inu akhakum, support your brother. And he did not stop there. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the first one. Rasul was the first one to plant a tree. The first tree to be planted as part of the process of freeing Salman, Radwanullahi alayhi, was planted by Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasul intend to eliminate the concept of slavery completely. Part of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mission is for each one of us, male or female, to have a direct communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a society when female did not really have any voice, when a female did not have really any value, when people used to inherit the females, when a man would to die, they will you can ask what did he left as a wealth behind. People might say to you, he left this amount of animals and he left how many wives or how many slaves, the female. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and he said, An-nisa'u shaqa'iqu rijal. An-nisa'u shaqa'iqu rijal. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us as his people and taught the human family that you know what, male and female are equal in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And actually the females in Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam really took this seriously, and they felt comfortable to speak about anything, anytime. Sayyida Ummu Salama went to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Ya Rasulallah, lam aqra' an al-muhajirati shay'an fi kitabillah. Sayyida Ummu Salama went to the ayat mentioning the Muslimin, the one migrated from Mecca to Medina, and she said, Ya Rasulallah, I didn't hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking about us, about the females. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam listened to her. And the Sayyidina Jibreel came with ayat among them, Inna al-Muslimina wal-Muslimat wal-Mu'minina wal-Mu'minat. The Quran came to confirm and to appreciate what the effort of the females within the society. As-Sahabiyat, the female companions, were empowered by our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Part of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mission to move the society from a system being corrupt, while a few percentage of the society is really controlling most of the wealth, to empower everyone. And the system of zakah in Islam came to move people from really being weak or in the receiving end of a charity to qualify to be given zakah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that part of our mission should be to bring a quality of each one's life. Quality of each one's life. Everyone, Muslim or people of other faith, were comfortable within the Muslim community. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to do this. when someone came approaching him, asking for a charity, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guided him to find the job and to become a wealthy individual. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam assisted him. When speaking about the message and the mission of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we often say, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. I hope that all of us can realize that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not only come to protect the human family, but the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to protect any creatures even around us. The Sahaba radwanullahi alayhim, they said, نَهَانَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ عَنْ أَنْ نَتَّخِذَ الطَّيْرَ غَرَضًا. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid us to hunt for fun. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid us to learn how to shoot by shooting a live being. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbid them from doing that. When the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was passing by two of the companions and they were chatting while riding their horses, فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اركبوها سالما ودعوها سالما ولا تتخذوها كراسيا لأحاديثكم. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he saw the two of the companions chatting while riding, sitting on their own horses, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ride your animal comfortably and leave the animal after finishing, and don't consider your animal to be like a chair you can use to chair over. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to protect not only the animals, but I said anything around us. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam nahana. The Rasul forbid us from even cutting a branch from a tree. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with his mission to bring equality, to guide the human family, to support each other. And when someone is asking, how can we do that? We say to everyone, a Muslim should learn from our beloved Prophet to be like someone wearing a perfume. You don't have to say to anyone that you have a nice expensive perfume with a nice smell. The perfume should speak for itself. People will smell, they will get the nice smell coming out of you by being a good and decent individual. Decent individual will empower everyone around you without having to speak a lot about your mission. The mission of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was accomplished when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدَ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ يعني توابا. When people ask us, why do you want to share in Islam with others? We say to them, we see Islam to be a special gift, a proper way of life. And if you want to enjoy your life 100%, you should adopt and implement in your life what your Creator designed for you. Islam is a beautiful message. Islam is a special gift. This is why we choose not to be selfish, but we choose to share this gift with everyone around us. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's mission was accomplished when he eliminated the concept of nationalism. When people sit together as brothers and sisters without any regard to color or financial position. When we speak about Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's mission and we appreciate what he did, I should say, I can be saddened, because sometimes we sense certain discrimination even within our own community. And if we can all realize that part of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mission to build a community with harmony, to see everyone around you as your brothers and you as your sisters, I think we have to realize that without practicing what Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did, we will not be able to reach his achievement. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's mission led him really to care deeply about the message without much worries about his own position. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he taught the Sahaba that he will not have any wealth left for his own family. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam allowed the female within his own family to speak about each minute in his own life. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم did not have a private and a public life. Each one of us sometimes we have this area where we like to hide information. الرسول said حدثوا حدثوا ولا حرج. Speak. السيدة عائشة and other females within الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم the family spoke with us about everything الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, did, or الرسول agreed with to the point if even of to the point of conveying to us that even the private moment they had with الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. الرسول's mission was to bring stability, to be part of creating a good society for all without discrimination. This is why in the Rasul's masjid, male and female both had voice, and the kids had voice. Part of the Rasul's mission to bring an inclusive society. The Rasul was receiving a revelation, had a contact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Jibreel. Although he had all of this, but the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say to Sahaba, Ashiru alayhi, give me your opinion. He did not say to them this to be kind or nice only, but the Rasul took their opinion seriously. If you enter any masjid today and you watch the member that our imams choose to give the khutbah on Friday from, this member was an idea of a female in the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam time. One of the female companions said, Ya Rasulullah, I have a carpenter. Let me do something for you. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. Part of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mission to do good for everyone. After the treaty of Hudaybiyah, the Rasul become aware of financial trouble the people of Mecca were going through. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, although the treaty of Hudaybiyah was troubling a little bit, and some of the Sahaba, especially Umar, really expressed concern about the details of the treaty, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, we will send to them assistant. We'll send to them assisting. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's mission was to convey to all of us what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from everyone. Ya ayyuha al-Rasulu, balligh ma ursila ilayka min rabbik, in alayka illa al-balagh. In the other ayah, the Rasul's mission was to bring the best out of everyone. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina wa maulana Muhammad wa ala ikhwanihi min al-mursaleen wa ajma'na Allahumma ma'ahum fi jannati al-na'im.
JazakAllah khair, Dr. Osama, for a beautiful reminder about the mission of our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You covered so many different aspects of the mission, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to comprehend and understand all these aspects and apply them in our lives.